Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel, Sparkle English, where I teach you how to improve your level of English. This is a new video on colon rules and how to use colons in sentences. This is the fifth video in my English Writing Essentials videos, so if you haven't already, make sure to subscribe to Sparkle English, and you can check out my other videos in this series on how to use commas, quotation marks, apostrophes, how to capitalize, and other different videos I have that are essential to helping you become a better English speaker and writer. So let's get started. In this lesson, you will learn how to use colons correctly when writing in English. So this here is a colon. And this is a semicolon. I will discuss semicolons in my next video, but today we're going to focus on colons. Colons have many different uses. They can be used to introduce a quotation, an example, a series, or an explanation. They can also be used to separate two independent clauses. And finally, a colon can be used to show emphasis. So we're going to go through each of these sections one by one and also have some practice for you at the end of this video. So the first rule is use a colon to introduce an item or list if the list comes after a complete sentence. For example, we need many things for the party: cups, napkins, ice, and balloons. You can see here we have placed a colon after party. I want you to view the colon almost like an arrow, because it's pointing to the things that we need for the party. We can almost use the colon, it almost means which is or which are the following. So when we use a colon to introduce an item or list, it's almost like saying we need many things for the party, which are cups, napkins, ice, and balloons. But rather than writing which is or which are, we just have to place a colon. The next example. Last year, I visited many countries: Spain, Italy, Portugal, and France. Again, we're using a colon. And again, it's like saying which are. Last year, I visited many countries, which are Spain, Italy, Portugal, and France. The colon connects these two clauses. This first is an independent clause, and this here is a dependent clause. And we can use the colon to connect the two to make one full sentence. She has had three boyfriends: Kyle, George, and Aaron. Again, we're using the colon, and it's like an arrow pointing to the boyfriends that she just spoke about in the first sentence. Okay? We can also use colons to provide further clarification in a sentence. For example, we have two options: eat at home or go to a restaurant. We use the colon here because we're providing further clarification in the sentence. We have first stated that there's two options, and now we use the colon, which is again like an arrow, and like saying which are eat at home or go to a restaurant. These are the two options we have. The next example, I'm not sure what to do: quit my job or stay for another year. Again, we're using a colon to connect these two clauses. Because if you just put a period after do, I'm not sure what to do, period, quit my job or stay for another year, it's separating these two statements that should be connected. Because quit my job or stay for another year is directly connected to this independent clause here, I'm not sure what to do. We can also use colons to show emphasis. Example: she was always there for one person, her mother. We want to emphasize who she was always there for, so we have to put a colon. We have a full sentence, a full independent clause here: she was always there for one person, And then we use the colon to emphasize that the mother is who we're talking about. If this sentence was, she was always there for her mother, you wouldn't need a colon. But here they're trying to emphasize that her mother was the person that she was there for. I finally met my lifelong hero, Nicolas Cage. We have one goal, win this tournament. Again, we're using the colon to provide emphasis and connecting these two sentences, which are directly related. We can also use colons to separate independent clauses. A colon can be used to separate two independent clauses when the second clause is directly related to the first clause and when the emphasis is on the second clause. In other words, we use a colon to join two independent clauses when the second clause is a definition, explanation, or summary of the first. You can also use a semicolon or a period between two independent clauses that are related. So if you look here, here are some examples. The results were in. Madonna had won the Grammy. Both of these are two independent clauses. These are two sentences that work by themselves. The results were in. Madonna had won the Grammy. You could put a period here, or you could just put a semicolon. But because this second independent clause is directly related to this first independent clause, it's better to use a colon, because this all works together as one sentence. These are the results that they're talking about in this first sentence. Another example, the judge made her decision. We lost the case. Again, these two sentences are directly related and the emphasis is on the second independent clause. We lost the case. Again, it's directly related to the first sentence, so we use a colon. You can also use a colon before a quote when the quote is introduced by a complete sentence. So let's look at some examples. In the first example, we're just going to use a comma. Jack said, comma, let's go to the cinema. Here we're going to use a comma because this is just two words. The whole sentence, Jack said, you need to connect that with a comma because it doesn't work by itself. It's not a complete independent clause, Jack said. You have to say what Jack said. So we just use a comma here. Jack said, let's go to the cinema. But in the second one, it's a complete sentence. Jack had one rule, colon, we will not watch a horror movie. So in this case, we would use a colon because this is a complete sentence. She advised, bring a jacket tomorrow. Again, we can use a comma here and not a colon because she advised does not work all by itself. It works with bring a jacket tomorrow because that is the advice. She offered the following advice, colon, bring an umbrella because it's going to rain tomorrow. Again, here we'd use a colon because this is a complete sentence. You could also use a comma, but in this case, a colon also works because this is a complete sentence that is introducing the quote. We also use colons to introduce a bulleted or numbered list. So if you were doing a PowerPoint presentation or creating a flyer or pamphlet, you would use colons to introduce this list. This is also common if you're using colons on your website, for example. In today's lesson, we will practice colon, grammar, punctuation, spelling, writing. Campers need to bring, colon, backpack, jacket, water bottle, hiking boots. Okay, so now we're going to do some practice and see what you have learned from this lesson. Which of these sentences require colons? So some of them do not require colons, so I want to see if you can tell the difference of when we need to use colons and when we don't. I recommend you take a piece of paper and try to see if you can write down which sentences you think need colons and which ones you don't, and then see how many you get right out of seven. We have seven. So let's see how many you can get right out of seven. The results were in. We had a new president. There are three countries in North America: Canada, the United States, and Mexico. The three countries in North America are Canada, the United States, and Mexico. After university, I want to travel to Australia, New Zealand, and China. I will travel to three places after university: Australia, New Zealand, and China. I'll never forget his last words: "You can do anything you put your mind to." I couldn't decide what to do: stay with him or break up with him and start over. Okay, so pause this video if you want to think about it before you hear the answers. So let's get started with the first one. The results were in: we had a new president. Here, we're going to put a colon after "in." The results were in: we had a new president. We're doing this because we're separating two independent clauses that are directly related. We're putting the emphasis on "we had a new president" because those are the results of the election or of the campaign. There are three countries in North America. Now we're going to put a colon afterwards because we are introducing a list: Canada, the United States, and Mexico. Now, the third sentence is what might get people to be a bit confused. This says the three countries in North America are Canada, the United States, and Mexico. Some people might think that you have to put a colon here, but this is incorrect. We do not need to put a colon here because we have the word "are," and this verb to be, "are," connects this sentence. You don't need a colon or semicolon or anything because the full sentence is the three countries in North America are Canada, the United States, and Mexico. Whereas in the second sentence here, there is no word connecting these two parts, so we have to use a colon because this sentence here is introducing the list. The next one: after university, I want to travel to Australia, New Zealand, and China. Again, you might be tempted to put a colon here after "to," but that would be incorrect. You do not need and you cannot use a colon there because you have the word "to." So this sentence was correct on its own. After university, I want to travel to Australia, New Zealand, and China. I'm going to erase these so it's not going to be confusing for you. Both of these sentences are correct as they are. What about this next one? I will travel to three places after university. Here we put a colon: Australia, New Zealand, and China. Again, remember that this colon here works like an arrow, pointing and saying which are the following. So I will travel to three places after university, which are the following: Australia, New Zealand, and China. This colon connects these two clauses. I'll never forget his last words: "You can do anything you put your mind to." Here we're going to put a colon after "words" because we have a full sentence that introduces the quote. And the last one: I couldn't decide what to do: stay with him or break up with him and start over. Here we're going to put a colon after "do." I couldn't decide what to do: stay with him or break up with him and start over. Because this second part is directly connected to this first independent clause, and it's giving more information about this first sentence, emphasizing these two options: stay with him or break up with him and start over. Okay? So I want to see how many you got out of 7. There should be 5 colons that we use. And if you already knew that these two here were correct, then you would get 7 out of 7 correct. Okay? So thank you very much for watching this video. I hope this made sense to you. I know colons can be a little difficult, but the more you practice, the more you will become used to using colons. You often see colons in more formal writing, or in novels or essays or articles that you read online. In casual writing to your friends and family and things like that, we don't typically use colons. In my next video, I will teach you how to use semicolons, and we will compare a little bit the difference between colons and semicolons. Thank you once again for watching. I encourage you to practice in the comments section and try to write your own sentences using colons. And if you haven't already, make sure to subscribe to Sparkle English for more videos on how to improve your level of English so you can become a better English speaker, writer, listener, and reader. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in my next tutorial.